thought this would never happen to me, but I got hit by a car while walking in BGC. Every day, millions of Filipinos commute to and from the greater metropolitan area in Manila, which results in hours of traffic every day and delays, delays, delays. This has led to a habit of reckless driving and complete disregard for many regulations. Now, a lot of the times people see the driving situation or the style of driving in Manila as something that is humorous or funny, but it stops being funny when it comes to the safety of pedestrians. You see, pedestrians are the most vulnerable participants of traffic in Manila, and especially in Manila, it is almost impossible for pedestrians not to get involved into the traffic situation, getting out of jeepneys, getting out of buses, trying to commute. They always have to kind of pass through cars and vehicles on the road. And sadly, a lot of the times, drivers see this vulnerability as a weakness, and they will cut off, honk at, or in worst case, even bump pedestrians, as I got to experience myself yesterday.
So here we have the pedestrian crossing where it happened. It's the one on the far end.
Yesterday after a meeting, we were coming here to Landmark to get some groceries. So we had a bunch of papers in our hand from the meeting itself, and then we had a bunch of groceries and we tried to cross the road right here. So this was a little bit later in the afternoon and there was more traffic, but cars were standing. It was a red light here, and then the armor truck stopped in front of the pedestrian crossing. We both stepped into the pedestrian crossing to cross, and I made eye contact with him, and as we were in the road, he accelerated and basically cut us off, and it was like he could have gone over our feet. It was very irresponsible.
And it was traumatizing at the same time.
Yeah.
As a pedestrian, I mean, I'm mostly a pedestrian more than a driver myself. You are mostly a driver as opposed to being a pedestrian.
Yeah.
And I have so much trust in drivers, thinking they know, they went to driving school and all the regulations mandated by the Philippine government should be something that they know. Traffic rules, roads rules, everything, they should be aware of that.
Yeah.
And it's the first thing that they teach you in driving school is pedestrians always have the first right of way.
And
this, that's kind of traumatizing.
This here is supposed to be a safe zone. It's supposed to be an area of safety, and if you can't rely on that safety, what is the purpose of it even? There's signs around here that say yield for pedestrians. There's markings on the road. It is very clear that this is a safe zone for pedestrians to cross, and cars in Manila just don't respect it, like this guy rushing over the road while there's still pedestrians in the middle of the road.
Yield! Look, he's not yielding. And okay, here, this is a good driver. Perfect.
I think if we just wait here long enough, we can see every 2 or 3 minutes somebody being cut off by traffic passing over the road, which is not right. He did exactly what happened yesterday. So irresponsible. Now, as you can see, obviously I didn't get hurt, but this is an ongoing issue in Manila. And the saddest thing of all, this isn't actually the first time that this has happened to me. In general, Filipinos are known for their hospitality and for being very friendly and kind, but for some reason, when they get into cars and they are in traffic in Manila, all of that changes. Because you see, reckless driving, especially in Manila, is very, very common. But let's just take a look at what the law actually says about the situation. Let's see what the LTO says about this. Now, the LTO issued driving school book clearly states the rules and regulations concerning pedestrians and pedestrian crossings. However, these rules are often ignored by drivers, putting pedestrians at risk.
Pedestrians. Give way to pedestrians at crossings, pavements, and intersections. Slow down where there is a high volume of pedestrians. Those with disabilities may need extra time to cross the road. Exercise extreme caution in approaching the pedestrian lane. Filipino Driver's Manual, Republic of the Philippines Land Transport Office.
And as dramatic as
pedestrians. Give way to pedestrians at crossings, pavements, and intersections. Slow down where there is a high volume of pedestrians. Those with disabilities may need extra time to cross the road. Exercise extreme caution in approaching the pedestrian lane. Filipino Driver's Manual, Republic of the Philippines Land Transport Office.
may sound, this is a reality that many people in Manila face every day, and it's up to us to make a change. I saw a statistic that is really shocking, and I want you to listen to this. Road traffic injury is now the leading cause of death for children and young adults aged 5 to 29 years. The leading cause of death. And it seems like the government is trying to combat this. The government is trying to do something. The government is trying to get people to be more careful and more conscious drivers. There even was this paper issued, and it is called the Pedestrian Safety Act, Section 44F. So the law and regulation couldn't be any clearer, and I'm going to read this off the Safety Act, Section 44F. The driver of a vehicle shall yield the right of way to a pedestrian crossing the roadway within any marked crosswalk or with any unmarked crosswalk at an intersection except otherwise provided in the section. So a car always has to yield for pedestrians crossing the road on a crosswalk. If it is not a crossway, the pedestrian shall yield the right of way to the vehicle. But even then, according to this, the driver of the vehicle shall continue to exercise due care for the safety of any pedestrian upon a roadway. So even if a pedestrian is in the road and needs to cross, if the pedestrian is there already, the car needs to yield to assure the safety of the pedestrian. It doesn't say honk at the pedestrian. It doesn't say threaten the pedestrian or drive up really fast to the pedestrian or even bump it. It says ensure the safety of the pedestrian. And that is a key thing that people need to learn. And I notice it myself when I'm driving in Manila and it is a road that has more lanes. I get extremely nervous because I stop at every crossway to let people pass over the road. And I have actually started to block two lanes with my vehicle because I am afraid that somebody's gonna overtake me on the right side and run over a pedestrian. I would just feel very guilty if that would happen. So I position the car in a way to protect any pedestrians that are currently crossing a roadwalk, especially if it's children or elderly. And I think everybody that drives in Manila bears the responsibility to do the same thing, to take care of the pedestrians. So in my situation, I was really upset because I had made eye contact with the armored vehicle and I was on the road already. I was on the crosswalk, the zebra stripes in BGC. I was on the road, had eye contact with him. He saw me. He saw me walking into the road and he still drove into the crossroad, which ended up with me bumping into the side of the car. And I actually gave the car a big slap with my hand just to get some reaction from this guy. But he just drove off like it was nothing. Very, very immature and very, very dangerous. Because people can, I mean, it's an armored vehicle, whatever, you would have driven over my foot. This was all happening at very slow speeds, okay, and I didn't get injured. But my foot could have gotten underneath the wheel. If there's a child that sees there's other people walking over the road, a child could run into the road and get in front or underneath the vehicle. It has happened a lot that children got stuck underneath cars in Manila. It happened recently with a big SUV. So drivers really need to pay a little bit more attention and really listen to the laws and yield to pedestrians crossing the road. It is not going to cost any more time, especially in this case. It was a red light. He would have had to wait in any case. There was stop and go traffic. There was no reason to incur into the pedestrian crossway. So anyway, I want to hear from you guys. Have you had similar situations? There must be people out there that have had the same issue, the same problem. I know it has happened to me at least a dozen times that I was crossing the road and a taxi driver would just cut me off as a pedestrian. Cars would accelerate when they see pedestrians are trying to cross the road. It is a very, very bad habit and it really needs to stop because traffic in Manila is not going anywhere. It's going to get worse. So we need to make sure that everybody in this traffic environment is safe. Anyway, that was my little rant on the vlog today because I was thinking about it all day yesterday because I really got upset because this time I had eye contact with the driver. There's no way that he didn't know that I was there. There's no way that he didn't know that we were in the road crossing. He had no right to cut us off and endanger our lives. So yeah. That's my story for today. Let me know what you guys think about the situation in the comments below. Let me know if you have experienced something similar and let's all try and be a little bit more safe on the roads.